My friend Mervin and his wife had a race yesterday, and I missed it. And I really wanted to see it, so I asked them, do you have a recording of it? And they said yes. So I said, good, give it to me. And they gave me this. A position time graph of what happened. So let's look at this graph and see if we can figure out what happened at the race, who won the race, and who was faster. So a position time graph gives us the position of any object at any instant of time. For example, this is Mervin's graph. It says that at time zero, he was at zero. This is the starting line, let's say. At 1 second, he is over here at 1 meter. At 2 seconds, he is at 2 meters and so on. And at the 6 second, he is at 6 meters at the finish line. So what we see from his graph is that it took him 6 seconds to finish the race. Now let's look at his wife. That's his wife, Nichelle. Where was she at zero? Well, at time zero, she's not in the picture at all. There is no graph of her. Ooh, that means she started late. That kind of makes sense. She's always late for things. At 1 second, again, she's not there. Nowhere to be seen. At 2 seconds, that's where she is at the starting line. Can you see that? She is at the starting line at 2 seconds. Okay, let's see what happens at the 3rd second. At 3 seconds, she is already at 3 meters. Wow, she is fast. You see that? At 2 seconds, she was at zero. At 3 seconds, she's already at 3 meters. At 4 seconds, she is already at 6 meters. She has finished the race. She wins at the 4th second. Mervin takes 6 seconds to finish the race. She took only 4 seconds, in fact, really 2 seconds, because she came late to finish the race. So clearly, she won the race, and we can now kind of visualize what must have happened. And so clearly, she was way faster than him. So let's see if we can now figure out what were their velocities. Let's start with Mervin. So what was Mervin's velocity for the entire race? Well, how do we calculate velocity? We calculate velocity as displacement over time. We have the time and we have the displacement. So can you pause for a while and see if you can figure out Mervin's velocity yourself? Go ahead, pause, give it a try. All right, so Mervin's velocity, we'll call it as Vm. We will calculate over the entire 6 seconds. You can calculate over any time you want, but let's calculate over 6 seconds. So over the 6 seconds, his displacement was 6 meters. So his displacement was 6 meters. His time taken for the displacement was 6 seconds. And so his velocity turns out to be 1 meter per second. So he travels 1 meters every second. Now let's calculate Nichelle's velocity. Again, can you give it a try? Can you find out what Nichelle's velocity is? Go ahead, give it a try. Okay, hopefully I've tried. Let's see, we'll do the same thing. Velocity for Nichelle would be, again, her displacement by time. So she starts over here, and she ends the race over here. So we have to consider this time from 2 second to 4 second, right? So what was the displacement? Again, her displacement is from 0 to 6. So that's 6 meters. Her displacement is 6 meters. And how long it took her to do that displacement? It's not 4 seconds. She ends at 4, but she started at 2. So it took her 2 seconds to do that. Does that make sense? It took her 2 seconds to do that. And so that will equal 6 divided by 2. That is 3 meters per second. So she was faster than Mervin. Of course, we had already figured that out, but her velocity is 3 meters per second. And now comes something super important to understand. That is, if you look at Mervin's graph one more time, what you see is that every second he's traveling 1 meter. First second, he travels 1 meter. Another second, he travels another meter. Next second, again, he travels another meter. He is constantly traveling 1 meter every second. And that means his velocity is a constant. It's not changing. It's steady. It's a uniform motion. And that's happening in the graph because the graph is a straight line. And the same is the case for Nichelle as well. She is constantly traveling every second 3 meters. First second, 3 meters. Second, 3 meters. Again, uniform motion because it's a straight line. So whenever position time graphs are straight lines, it means the position is changing uniformly. Every second, same amount of change, which means the velocity is a constant. On the other hand, if the graph was not a straight line, if it was some kind of a curve like this, then we would see the position won't change uniformly. And that means the velocity is not a constant. And of course, we've spoken a lot about this in previous videos. So if you need more clarity, great idea to go back, watch those videos, and then come back over here. Also, another important thing you can note is that Nichelle, who has a higher velocity, her graph is steeper compared to Mervyn's graph, who has a lower velocity. Can you see that? What I mean to say is, if you treated this as mountains, and if you were to climb these mountains, so let's say you were climbing these mountains, can you see to climb this graph, it's a little harder because it's more steep. This is easier to climb because it's less steep. And so this means in a position time graph, if something is steeper, that means it has a higher velocity. It kind of makes sense, right? More steep, that means quicker is the change in the position. And so at a glance, just by looking at which one is more steep, we can figure out which one has more velocity. All right, one last thing. It turns out there was another competitor in the race. There was a dog as well. And here is its position time graph. So can you figure out what this dog did in this race and find out what its velocity was? I'm pretty sure you can. Please give it a try. All right, let's see. At time zero, where is our dog? Well, it's over here. It starts directly at 4 meters. And then at 1 second, it is somewhere below. That means the dog is traveling in the opposite direction. And at the end of 5 seconds, notice, it is back to the starting position. And so our dog is traveling in the opposite direction. That's what the graph is saying. So now let's go ahead and figure out what its velocity was. So we'll call that velocity as V of D. Again, displacement over time. If we take 5 seconds as the time, then initially the dog was over here. Finally, at the end of 5 seconds, the dog is over here. So what's the displacement? Now, we might think it's 4 seconds, but it's not. We might think it's 4 meters, but it's not. Why not? Because notice it starts here and comes down. And so it's -4 meters. Another way to think about it is that displacement is final position minus the initial position. So it's 0 minus 4, which is -4, right? And so anyways you think about it, you see his displacement is -4. It's traveling in the opposite direction. And how long it took him to do that? Well, it took it 5 seconds. So divide by 5 seconds. That gives us negative 4 over 5 is 0.8. You can check that. It's negative minus 0.8 meters per second. Pretty slow. And the negative sign is implying that our dog is going in the opposite direction. Even here, if you think in terms of the mountain, notice you are no longer climbing the mountain, right? As you go forward, you end up going downwards. Another way to see why it's the opposite of what we had before. Before, you're climbing up, which we call as positive. Now you're going down, which we call as negative. However you want to see it, the dog has a negative velocity because it's traveling in the opposite direction. So what did we learn? We learned how to analyze position time graphs. We figured out how to calculate velocities from it. And we also saw if the graphs are straight line, it means the position is changing uniformly. In other words, it's a uniform motion. Velocities are constants.